The engineering community is plagued by a stereotype that we are a silent profession. Brilliant technical minds that aren't heard from until disaster strikes, till the bridge collapses or the drinking water is contaminated.
As professionals, we spend a lot of time learning about our ethical and legal responsibilities, but we spend perhaps less time on figuring out how to share our knowledge and our perspective.
Look at the teachers, you look at the lawyers. They are organized much more than the engineering profession is. And I think that's a shame, because when you look at any profession in Ontario, and you look at them all, I think engineers have the most often when it comes to public policy, because engineers are natural problem solvers. So the engineering community is fractured. When it comes to advocacy, we need a unified voice, and right now there isn't one.
So one of the biggest challenges we have is how do we work together to make our voices heard, to provide the best message for Ontario's engineers, and to ensure it's getting out there, and to ensure that it's a consistent message, and to ensure that it's one that's properly delivered.
We are at a moment where we need the expertise and wisdom and advice of engineers more than any other time. And that isn't just around infrastructure renewal, that isn't just around climate change.
As engineers, how do we make our voice stronger so that what is being done or what is going forward with is the things that are the right decision and right for the public?
It requires, I think, not just governments to think about engineers, but engineers to continue to put themselves on the table as very relevant. And I think that their relevance is only going to grow over the next decade.
What I have learned in my almost 30 years of public policy advocacy, I'd like to share with you. And I'm going to break it down in three ways. First of all, about process. Secondly, about credibility. And thirdly, about timing.
I can tell you the results of our media analysis shows that engineers are certainly not taken seriously by the media. Since March 2013, we found 4,095 articles focused on infrastructure. Out of these stories, two referenced an engineer. The fact of the matter is, engineers are not at the decision-making table in this province. If more engineers saw the importance of participating in the public discourse and the public conversation, perhaps the profession would be in a different position than it finds itself today.
One of the biggest issues in the country right now is infrastructure. If the engineers of Canada, either individually or collectively, have a point of view about whether we need to spend more money on infrastructure, if our infrastructure projects are being built and financed and managed properly, what the priorities for infrastructure ought to be, if the engineering profession has a point of view on any of that, I'm unaware of what it is, and I'm pretty involved in that issue.
First, you need to connect with the gatekeepers. You need to get to know the relevant editors, the editorial page editors, the opinion editors, columnists, reporters. Meet with them before you need them. Do your homework.
Change is driven by technology. And technology is driven by engineers, so we have a big impact on the society.
I think about the opportunities that engineers have to engage in a wide variety of policy debates on issues like climate change, infrastructure, the automotive sector, even income inequality. There's a huge potential for engineers to really get involved and make a positive contribution.
We're definitely in the background, and we need to do a lot more to make ourselves more visible and effective in terms of the public eye and public policy.
I encourage people to get involved in these organizations and find ways to help make an impact. Submit op-eds to the newspaper, share your perspective on social media. If you're interested in mentoring engineering students or partnering with our researchers, please make yourself known and get involved. When you do make contributions, make it known that you're an engineer. Be an ambassador for your profession.